So who's at fault here? Is it the current government? Is it the previous Liberal government? Or is it Labor government before then? Look, I don't want to politicise this. I can show you the track record of each government, or each party if you like, and it's pretty ugly. The big hits, yes, they've come from Labor. But it's fair to say that the Liberals have had the opportunity, had they wished to correct those hits. And what were some of them? Well, there's been a number. You could go back, if you like, back to 1948 when the original Defence Force Retirement Benefits Scheme started. I don't want to go back that far, but I can if someone wanted to. But the real hit started when we came across to the new, which is improved in many ways, the DFRDB scheme that was introduced as an act in 1973. There, the members started contributing compulsory amount of their wage into that fund, taxed, I might add. And then 2 years later, the public servants came along and they got a slightly different and more generous scheme. They were only charged or docked 5% of their salary versus 5.5% for the military. Their spouse, were they to pass away, received 68% of the residual pension versus 62%. Then in the mid-80s, the Keating government came along and said, we're going to stop paying this CPI index and we're going to reduce it by 2% for 3 consecutive years. And so everyone that was on a pension, every serviceman and every Commonwealth public servant for that matter, that was on a pension at that time, effectively had 6% ripped out of their pension, never to be seen again. So it carries forward for life, that reduction. It goes on. We've now moved on to a new military superannuation scheme, so the old DFRDB is closed. But that doesn't mean to say that people aren't impacted. There's 63,000 troops out there still being paid. And can I tell you, to just dispel this fat cat attitude that some people have, 90%, or I better be right, 89.8% of those superannuants in the DFRDB scheme are receiving less than $30,000 a year. $30,000. They're not fat cats, I can assure you. They're struggling to make ends meet. Why? Because the indexation is not keeping pace. What do we want? Just what the government is now giving the age pensioners. The pensioner and beneficiary cost of living index, it correctly indexes. It's what the government knows is fair. It's what the four Labor politicians wrote to the then Minister of Finance, Tanner, and said this is what should happen. Give us the indexation that you're giving the aged pensioners in this country and we'll walk away happy. We're not asking for the politician super special indexation that they're all getting, or they were getting until their schemes closed in 2004. But don't get me wrong, just like ours, it might be closed, but all those that are on it continue to get it. That would be nice, but we're not being greedy. We haven't got our noses in the trough. We just want what is fair, and what is fair is what you're paying the pensioners in this country. Let's look at the last 10 years. In 10 years, the politicians' retirement has gone up 91%. The pensioners gone up 97%, the servicemen's 33%.